Is it possible to make HD look like 4K? 4K like 8K? If so, is it just a case of mild deception, or does the image actually increase in resolution? I recently used upscaling software and the results were nothing short of mind-blowing. I got the idea while editing my show reel with the desire to use a few older shots I filmed in 1080p. Now, being the pixel peeper that I am, it just didn't look right next to my 4K clips. I remember seeing some videos about AI software, which at the time seemed a little too good to be true. But desperate to use my HD footage, I gave it a shot. In case you're wondering, all the clips I've shown so far are 1080p upscaled to 4K. Some shot at 100 frames per second and some at 50. When you compare the HD version with the upscaled 4K version, you'll clearly notice the increase in detail, especially when zoomed in 100%. Yet there's no oversharpening or funny artifacts, and somehow there's even less noise. So what exactly is this voodoo? Meet Topaz Video AI. I downloaded the trial version to test it, but after the first render, I was hooked. Now, that being said, this video is not sponsored by Topaz. I bought the software with my own money and I simply love the results that I got from it. And I do believe that some of you will also benefit from using it. I did sign up for their affiliate program, so if you want to get it for yourself, you can support my channel by using the link in the description below. Who is it for? Well, pretty much everyone. If your camera doesn't do high frame rates in 4K, now you can upscale your HD videos to match your 24-25p 4K clips. Cameras like the A7S III can do 240 frames per second in HD, and the potential to match my other 4K shots immediately makes the camera more attractive. Even if you can shoot high frame rates in 4K, you can always upscale to 8K to allow for better crops and post zooms, something my showreel is full of. On top of that, Topaz also has the best frame interpolation I've ever seen. Making clips slower than the frame rates they were shot at, but still getting smooth results, is a great option when you need it. From slowing down clips that were not filmed in slow-mo, to making slow-mo clips even slower, it's about having options even when the camera doesn't agree. The fact that software can add more value to any camera is just insane, and I'm excited to see it evolve even more going forward. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.